पोषयता सन्तौ श्रीलरूपसनातनौ दाक्षिणात्येन भट्टेन पुनरेतद्विविच्यते तस्याद्यं ग्रन्थनालेकं क्रान्तव्युत्क्रान्तखण्डितं पर्यालोच्यातपर्यायं कृत्वा लिखति जीवकः। हरे कृष्ण, वेलकम टू टुडेज भक्ति संदर्भ क्लास। ओके, आई होप यू ऑल ऑफ गेट फाइल्स फॉर टुडेज डिस्कशन। सो वी फिनिश्ड आवर डिस्कशन टिल 11th अनुच्छेद। यस, इज इट? So today we have to continue from 12th onwards. So we sent files into different, that means Sanskrit is in another file and English translation is another, separately. It's good. Let's see how you will experience today. If it is good, then we'll send like this so that you can immediately flip it and see. So tell me what you understood from the last anuchedas. So who is going to tell? So I requested devotees to add every day some slides for the PPT. Some team is there, our team. I hope it's going well and it will go well. So yes, sir. Yes, Leela Govind Prabhu, you want to say something about the from the last class?
Hare Krishna, Dandavat Pranam Prabhuji.
So, yes.
From the last, in
yes.
the last class, we discussed the Sutta Goswami's teachings. There are four processes he explains.
Yes.
So the discussion was like which process our ISKCON devotees follows.
Yes.
First concluded that. Even though the starting with like Shravanam Kirtanam, but
Srila Prabhupada incorporated
all the four processes.
What are the four?
Hare Krishna.
What are those four?
So I'm coming from the last. So where it is the first, last one is that, why should be engaged in all other things except Shravanam Kirtanam. Shushrusho Shraddha Dhanasya Vasudevak Taruchi.
Okay, some other ones. So who is going to tell? From on-site students? Anyone wants to say something?
హరితోషణం And once we do that, we develop katha ruchi, and that gives us prema. This is one process.
No. Okay. Prema means he will do once again Shravanam Kirtanam, then he will go to the prema.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Katha ruchi means rather nine processes.
Yes.
Should I explain other two also?
Remaining two?
Yeah. So the other one is one who goes to a spiritual master and Shruta Gruhikaya and hears shloka number, I think, 12th provision.
Yeah. What is that shloka?
Tashraddhana Munayo Jnana.
Yes.
Jnana Vairagya Yuktaya Pashyanti Atmani Atmanam. Pashyanti Atmani Atmanam.
Pashyanti Atmani Chatmanam.
Pashyanti Atmani Chatmanam. Bhaktya Shruta Gruhitaya.
Yes.
So where he goes to a spiritual master, from him he hears all the Vedic literatures.
Yes.
Okay. And then he becomes he attains the stage of Munayaha.
Yeah.
So where he develops faith, then Shraddhaya.
So, yeah, faith. Tas Shraddhadhana. Shraddha will come. First he will go. He will go and hear from Guru all the meanings of all the Shastras. So from that, Tashraddha, so Shruta Grihitaya, first step is Shruta Grihitaya. So that means, so student will go to the Guru and Guru will teach meanings of all the Shastras. So from this, he will understand bhakti is the essential activity or must be done by me. Like this, he will understand. Then after that, he'll be having some viparita bhavanas. So that means maybe karma should be done by me or jnana should be done by me. So like this kind of viparita bhavanas he might be having. Those will be removed by mananam. Mananam. So mananam will always, contemplation, so will remove the viparita bhavanas. So from after that, what will happen? So from after shravanam and mananam, next Shraddha he will get. That means he will firmly understand, he will get firm faith in bhakti. So then he will start worshipping. So after that, worshipping him, finally he will also, worshipping means Shravanam Kirtanam. He will do Shravanam Kirtanam. This Shravanam Kirtanam is holy names of the Lord, form, qualities and so. Before that, what he heard, that is all the Shastras. He tried to find so what is the conclusion of the Shastras? So that's a Srotavya Mantavya Nididhyasitavyascha Atmavare Drashtavya. That's Upanishad statement also is there. So there Shravanam means hearing all the Vedic literatures initially. So now after doing the Shravanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam Partha Sevanam Archanam Vandanam Ityadi, so finally he will come to the stage of Prema. So by that Prema, he is seeing the Atmanam, that means seeing the Supreme Lord Hari. Here you should take Atmanam means Hari. So in his heart by Bhakti. So that means, which is coming from this process, that Prema. Here you should take Bhakti means Prema. By that Prema, he is able to see. So that Bhakti is having the two children. So what are those? Jnana and Vairagya. So that's why from this we are understanding, so which are the products of the bhakti, jnana and vairagya. By these two, so optionally he can, if he wants, he can see absolute truth in the form of Brahman also by that jnana. But that is only his choice. It's not compulsory. Because those two are the byproducts. You may use or you may not use that. So that's generally any prema bhakta, he never wants to see Lord in the form of Brahman. Okay, so in this process, so like this, one is getting the bhakti. So it is that means bhakti is attained after a long endeavor. So that's why in this process, bhakti is durlaba, is very with a hard labor, it is attained. This is the one process. And yeah, so one more thing is, what proposition Sota Goswami is giving? Sota Goswami is saying, so that, 1 second. यदनुध्यासिना युक्ताः कर्मग्रंथि निबंधनम् छंदन्ति कोविदास्तस्य कोन कुर्यात् कथारतिम्. दिस श्लोक इज सेइंग वाय जस्ट द स्वाड अनु असि असि मीन्स स्वाड असिना यदनुध्यासिना युक्ताः कर्म ग्रंथि निबंधनम्. वन कैन ईजिली कट द कर्म ग्रंथि. कर्म ग्रंथि इज द कॉज for jiva to be binded to this material world, so that's why karma is the bonding element, binding element, so that karma can be cut down by the sword of meditating on the hari. So if one is able to meditate on hari, by that he can easily surpass this material world, this samsara. So chindanti kovidaha, so such a benefit is there in remembering the hari. So kona kuryat katharatim, so if you want to remember hari, what you should do, you should hear about him. So that's why, who will not do? If you have such a high benefit from the hari's meditation, so then who will not do? Anyone, any intelligent person should do. So That means by hearing the glories of the Hari, one can naturally get the Katharati. And then that means Katharati means here the basic interest. So by that he will also take up the process of Shravanam Kirtan seriously, and that stages of the bhakti he will pass and finally reach to the prema. So this is also one way intelligent people will simply by hearing the glories of the bhakti and hari, they can get attraction for the hari, and by that attraction they will follow the process of the navada bhakti, and then from that they will finally getting the prema. This also can happen. And yeah, this kind of things we have discussed. So ultimately from all these discussions we are seeing what Sota Goswami is trying to establish. So bhakti is ultimately katharati one should get, and then after that one will be so continually doing the shravanam kirtanam. This is recommended. What is our main goal? Our main goal is for the samukhyam. There are the various processes are there. So Paratattva Samukhyam can be achieved by the bhakti, karma, jnana and many. They are all Samukhyam only, all those sadhanas. But out of those sadhanas, bhakti is only the sadhana is recommended by the Shastra. So that we want to establish. So we already, that bhakti is the Samukhyam, we understood from the sloka bhayam ditiya viniveshitah ishada petasya viparyayo smritihi tanmaya abhajetam. There we are seeing abhajetam ekaya bhaktya. So there from the bhakti we understood already bhakti is the abhideya, but still we are trying to prove bhakti is the abhideya or the samukhyam, that is the process to recommended for the jiva to turn towards the paratattvam. So that is our point to establish that. So we took the prasanga, that means this conversation between the sutta and the saunuka. So sutta is saying so we started sutta's conversation from the 1.2.6 to 22 we are going to analyze. Till now we analyzed till what sloka? Till the 16. 16 is done. Then after that means we have seen four different kinds of the processes. Ultimately every process is merging where Vasudeva, Katha, Ruchi, and that should lead to the further process of Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam. This thing is happening actually. So that means Varnashram system also should finally lead to the Vasudeva, Katha, Ruchi. Any dharma you do, that means should be done for the Vasudeva, Katha, Ruchi, and also any Shastric studies, if you do, that also should lead to the, ultimately, bhakti is the conclusion. So, why? Srutta Grihitaya. Even after reading all the Srutis, all the Vedas, what should happen? Bhakti. Bhaktiya Srutta Grihitaya. So, Pashyanti Atmani Chatmanam Bhaktiya Srutta Grihitaya. That means after reading all the meanings of the Vedas, so one should come to the stage of getting the bhakti, that means the prema, so that you can see the Supreme Lord in your heart, whom jnana and vairagya are the products. So this process also is saying, and intellectually if you think also, yes, Hari is the Supreme. So if you remember Hari, that can give such a great advantage. And like this, we have seen Vasudeva Katharji should be the final thing. So next anucheda 12. Tatascha Shrinvatam Sakata Krishna Punyashravana Kirtana Hrudyantasto Hyabhadrani Vidhunoti Suhrutsatam. One second, I'm opening. So the translation, Krishna, hearing and chanting about whom is auspicious, who is the well-wisher of devotees, destroys impurities in the hearts of those who hear his topics while being present in the heart. Looking little difficult sentence, okay. So what is happening? So ultimately everything should lead to the Vasudeva Katha Aruchi, and then you have to should hear regularly, you should hear Krishna's names. If you hear Krishna's names, what will happen? Shrinvatam Swakatah Krishnaha, Swakatah Krishnaha Punya Shravana Kirtanaha Hrudi Antahastaha Hi Abhadrani Vidunoti. So main, what is the verb in this? Vidunoti. Vidunoti is the verb. What is the meaning of Vidunoti? Dhodalna. Cleaning. So destroying actually vidunoti. So who destroys? Who will destroy? Antastaha, the one who is inside. Hrudi antastaha, who is inside the heart. The one who is inside, that is Krishnaha. Krishna, who is inside the heart, he will do what? He will clean. He will clean what? What he will clean? Abhadrani. Abhadrani. He will clean all the impurities. Impurities of everyone? Whose impurities? Whose interior? Whoever hearing. That's why Suhrut Satam. Suhrut Satam. Sir, Satam. Whose impurities he is removing? Satam. Satam means devotees. So what kind of Krishna he is? So he is doing cleaning. Cleaning of your, if you chant his names and he is cleaning. That's why he is Suhrut. He is your well-wisher. And also Punya Shravana Kirtanaha. That means his glories are just by hearing his names. So such an auspicious thing is happening. So that means his glories are so auspicious. Punya Shravana Kirtanaha. So whose impurities he is clearing, destroying? Shrinvatam. Satam means Shrinvatam. So Satam, every devotees, whoever hearing. Not the all the devotees, whoever here. So they will wear dhoti, kurta and tilak, and Krishna will do that? No. You should hear, then only he will clear. Otherwise, no. So that's why, Shrinvatam Satam, whoever is hearing. Swakathaha, his own, his pastimes. So that means finally Krishna destroys impurities of the devotees whoever hearing his names. Being in the heart, Krishna is clearing where he is staying, where these are impurities are there. And the body? No, and in the heart. So, and he, where he is also going to heart. And he is staying there and he is clearing. So that means Krishna is going in inside the heart. So then he is inside the heart, then that means here one problem is coming actually. What is that? Krishna is appearing in the impurity heart also. That means Krishna is entering into the impurity heart also. This means. Yes. So here Krishna is entering into the everyone's heart. If you, that means whoever is hearing his names, so he is entering. So directly he is as it is, Krishna is entering or not? If directly he is entering, then what kind of problem will be getting? We are going to see. That means after we are going to see evam prasanna manaso bhagavat bhakti yogataha bhagavat tattva vijnanam mukta sangasya jayate. Actually, when everything is cleaned, then bhagavat tattva vijnanam, that means Lord is directly presenting in that heart. In after the next 2-3 slokas, after 3 slokas, we are going to read that. And now we are saying he is already entering into the heart. And after that 2-3 slokas, we are saying that when heart is completely purified, that means tada rajastamo bhavah kama lobhadayaschaye chetayetairanavittam sthitam sattve prasidati. We are saying by continually hearing his names, so heart is completely freed from the rajas and tamas, then it is coming into the stage of pure goodness. That means visuddha sattvam, not the goodness. So pure goodness, and in that pure goodness heart, so mukta sangasya, so bhagavat tattva vijnana mukta sangasya jayate. So whoever is cleaning their heart like this, in their heart he is going to appear. That we are going to see. So now here also we are seeing Krishna is there in the heart and cleaning the all the impurities. Then how to understand what is the difference between that Krishna and this Krishna? Is there any difference or both are one Krishna? So after cleaning, the Krishna is appearing. That and to clean, there is one more Krishna is there inside the heart. Both are same. Both are not same. Both are not same as two Krishnas are there. But the form is different actually. Krishna only, but so what is that? So when for the cleaning, who is there? Bhavana padavim gataha sat san. Bhavana padavim gataha san. See, Acharya is giving commentary on that. Katha dvara antastaha. If you hear Krishna katha, Krishna is entering into your heart in the form of bhava. Krishna consciousness. Krishna consciousness. Krishna bhavanamrutam. So he is entering into your consciousness. He is in the form of bhava. Bhava means not that bhava. After anardhanivritti. So anardhanivritti, nishta, ruchi, asakti, bhava. Not that bhava actually. Krishna bhava. Bhavana means is thought actually. Thought. So bhavana padavim gatahasan. That means Lord entering by the topics and being in the form of conception or thought. Destroys all lusty desires. Abhadrani. That's why every day you are chanting means every day cleaning is happening.
First time not Krishna appeared in heart. So before who is come and clean the heart?
First
who came? Clean the heart.
Bhavana. Bhavana Rupi Krishna. In the form of Bhavana, thought, conception. So Gatahasan Hrudi Abhadrani Vasanaha. Okay, next sloka. Your question?
Yeah.
Done, na? Okay. In this, Mula is here. You can see Mula, Prabhu. In the Mula, 12th Anusheda, Katha Dwara Antastaha Bhavana Padavim Gataha. He got the form of Padavi means state. Padavi means state. Bhavana Padavim Gataha. Son. That means he is getting the form of our state of Bhavana. Ashray Gaurang Prabhu, yes.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. From this commentary, it is coming like this that when we hear the Krishna Katha, then whatever Katha we are hearing, that Katha goes in our heart and it makes like kind of concept of God.
Yes.
And that concept is clearing our heart.
Yes.
But the sloka, the word is using Hridyanta Stho. Stho means it's already there, somebody is there already in the heart, existing in the heart already before. And Hridyanta Stho. So it appears like Paramatma in that context. But in the explanation, it appears like it is Bhavana Padve. Yeah. So this is little. Because Hridyanta Stho, it was there in the heart, someone is already existing.
Hrudyantastho is Sandhi Vichyad if you do. Hrudi Antastaha. That means Hrudi means inside heart. Antastaha means being there. That means situated, inside. Antaha means inside. Staha means staying. So, when he is staying, when you hear Katha, then only he is going and staying there. If you take already existing Paramatma is doing, then it should happen to everyone. There is a big apatti will come. What is that apatti? So if you take Paramatma is clearing, so Paramatma is there in everyone's heart, then why he is not doing?
There is an answer for that. Answer is that when Paramatma will see that this living entity is coming towards me, he's turning his face towards me by hearing Katha from the sadhu, then Paramatma helps the purify the heart.
Yeah, Paramatma's duties is what? Maya Jiva Nintrutva Shakti Yukta Kevala Gnanam. He is the controller of Jiva and the Maya. That means his action is witnessing and sanctioning, that's all. He will not do the action of cleaning, no. He doesn't want to do that. That is not the duty of Paramatma.
Yeah.
So, Krishna is doing in the form of Bhavana there. Gatahasan. Kathadwara antastaha bhavana padam gatha san hrudi abhadrani vasanaha. Next, tatascha. We'll go to next. Nashta prayeshva bhadreshu nityam bhagavatyuttama sloke bhaktir bhavati naishtiki. So every day we chant this mantra before starting bhagavatam. So what is staying? Tatascha, after that, what will happen? You can open your file and two files are easy, no? Actually, you can easily see. After that, So translation is like this: as the lusty desires become generally destroyed by constant service to the great devotees or Bhagavatam, so steady bhakti to Bhagavan, who is praised by the greatest sages, becomes established. So what? One will come to the stage of nishta. On the same slokas, Vishwanatha Chakra Thakur is giving the different commentary actually. So he is trying to establish or the 9 stages or 14 stages. He took 9 stages into 14, and he is explaining, that means subdivisions he did. So 14 stages of bhakti he is establishing from this same set of the slokas. So but Jiva Goswami in this is not doing that. So he is simply going with his own explanation. So here in this, what is happening? What is the kriya in this sloka? Bhavati is the kriya. Bhavati, so becomes or exist. Bhavati, kim bhavati, kim bhavati, what kim bhavati? Bhakti hi bhavati. So bhakti hi bhavati, bhakti appear or exist. So where, what kind of bhakti? Naishtiki bhakti. Bhakti in whom? Bhakti in whom? Bhakti to whom? Otherwise, to the Bhagavati. Uttama sloke. Uttama sloke Bhagavati. So this is happening. This bhakti, naistiki bhakti, is happening, or is becoming. So in Bhagavan. By what? This naistiki bhakti is coming by what? By what? Bhagavata sevaya. This will come, that means this seva should be done only one day. Nityam bhagavata sevaya. So that means continuously, if you do the service to the Bhagavat, then what will happen? Naistiki bhakti is appearing. So nashtaprayeshu abhadreshu, that means one will happen if you continuously chant. So these all the anarthas, abhadrani means the impurities, nashtaprayeshu, prayeshu is said, that means maximum 99%, not the complete. So almost, that means if you keep on hearing the holy names of the Lord, all the abhadras, all the impurities are destroyed, almost all destroyed, then what will happen? Naishtiki bhakti will appear. Will come to the stage of nishta. Okay. So now, in this, nashtaprayeshu, natu jnanamiva samyak nashteshu iti bhaktehe nirgala swabhavatvam uktam bhagavatanam bhagavata shastrasya cha sevaya bhaktihi anudhyana rupa naishtiki santata eva bhavati. Translation is like this for this Sanskrit. You can see here in English it is given. Even though impurities are not completely destroyed, bhakti can be performed without impediments, unlike the process of jnana, where the impurities have to be completely destroyed. This shows the unimpediment nature of bhakti. Bhakti in the form of meditation becomes constant by service to the great devotees or to Bhagavatam. So now Jiva Goswami is bringing a difference between the jnana and the bhakti. What is again jnana? Actually, in the jnana marga, what is the process we adapt? If one wants to be steadily, he wants to fix his consciousness on Brahman, what kind of demand is there? His heart completely. If one has to, in the Jnana Marga, what happens? Jnani, what he does? Gnani, what he does? He meditate on what? Paramatma. Nirakara Brahman. Brahman. Gnani is meditating on Brahman. So, for that steady meditation, what is demanding? Complete purification of the heart. Complete purification of the heart means what they do, Gnanis, what they do to the heart. In the process of Gnana, what is the process? Pratyahara. What is done in the process of Gnana to the heart? What is done? Heart will become non-reactive to the any objects from the outside to him. That means his heart will not respond to the any kinds of the objects. That is the that kind of perfection they should get. Actually, what happens now, if you see a rasagulla you ate few days back, and by seeing the rasagulla immediately your eyes are seeing that rasagulla, and what will happen? So that means antakarana vritti is coming out from the eyes, and it is going to the touching to the rasagulla, and the antakarana vritti is taking the shape of rasagulla, and the same shape is happening in the heart. That is, so now then you will be seeing the rasagulla actually. So what process happens? Seeing rasagulla means you are seeing the, so that object, what happens immediately? Antakarana vritti is coming out from the eyes, and there is indriya pranalika, that means canal. So from this, so vritti is passing and taking the shape of that object, and that same form, anantakarana, is formed. So now, oh, this is rasagulla. This information immediately you will get. Then after that, what will happen? There are some other impressions are there in your heart. So if I eat rasagulla, it will be very tasty. And I already ate long back. So now I want that. And let me try. But that rasagulla needs 10 rupees, but you don't have, then I should steal that. Or otherwise, I should ask him. But he's not my friend. So then how to ask him? So I should do something, some indirect way of asking or something. So what? These are all just keep on connecting to the various previous impressions, and all are just hold your consciousness. Now your consciousness is rasagulla consciousness. So now what you have to do? Jnanis, what they do? Their antakarana, that means when they see rasagulla, their antakarana will not take the form of rasagulla. Finish, game. So then no impressions on the heart. So everything they will see is one. No attributes. They don't see any attributes. If they see mobile, if they see marker, they are not seeing any shape difference or form difference or the utility difference. No. So what they see? Idam asti. Sarvam khalu idam brahma. Sab kuch. Everything. If you don't see the attributes of these two objects separately, so then what you will see is asti. Something is there. That's all. Nirvishesha jnanam, that is. So that means for that, what is necessary? Heart should not take the forms of those. And like this, his heart is completely, is becoming the avikriyat. Where it is said this process? This process is said in the 10th canto, 14th chapter, 6th sloka. Our great Brahmaji is explaining the process of this. How to become a jnani. Becoming jnani is easy. Becoming jnani means becoming the... So, knowing the Nirguna Brahman is easier than the... Knowing the all the attributes of the Saguna Brahman. It's impossible to know the all the features of Saguna Brahma. So, what is happening now? See, very important point Jiva Goswami is writing there. So, tathapi bhuman mahima gunaschate vibodhum arhatyamalantaratma bihi avikriyat. This is the important word. Swanubhavad arupataha ananya bodhyatmataya nachanyata. From where I am reading this sloka? 10th canto, 14th chapter, 6th sloka. So there it is explained the process of jnana. Through jnana, how to realize the Brahman. So for the Brahman realization, if you want to fix your consciousness on Brahman, so your heart should not change. That means completely purified. Purified means completely non-reactive. If little bit also is having the some reactiveness, gone. Gone. You cannot fix on your consciousness on Brahman. It's impossible. That means in the Jnana Marga, absolute demand is there. So destruction of impurities. But in the case of Bhakti, Nashta Prayeshu, maximum destroyed, okay, you can get Naistiki Bhakti. This is the glory of the Bhakti. Yes? No? No? Pitamar Prabhu, no? Oh, acha. Okay, no problem. So that's why this statement you should try to understand. Nashra prayeshu natu jnanamiva samyak nasteshu. Not like in the case of jnana. Samyak nasteshu means complete destruction is not necessary. Bhaktehe nirgala svabhavam uktam. So this shows the unimpeded nature of bhakti. Bold, what Prabhu? Nirgala, unimpeded nature. Okay, next anusheda. And also it is said, Bhagavata anam Bhagavata Shastrasya cha seva. Bhagavata sevaya means what you should take? Bhagavatanam means devotees and Bhagavata Sevaya. Bhagavata Shastrasya. Both. So cha sevaya bhaktihi anudhyana rupa. Here what? Anudhyana rupa naishtiki santata eva bhavati. Here bhakti means what you should take? Dhyana. Anudhyana rupa. So that means what will happen? By doing this Shravanam Kirtanam, Ado Shraddha, Sadhu Sangha, Bhajana Kriya, Anardhani Vritti, next Nishtha. So, what is the demand? That means Nishtha stage means is almost all like the meditation type. Anudhyana Rupa. So, it's continuously you are able to remember. So, by doing this Shravanam and Kirtanam, what will happen? One will be entering into the stage of Smaranam automatically. Smaranam cannot be tried artificially without purifying the heart, without removing the impurities. So you should not try for the Smaranam. It is not recommended actually. In the coming stages, in the coming Anuchedas, we are going to see. So many people, they try to meditate on the Lord. by seeing the some other sadhus in Vraj, so they are meditating actually. And what this ISKCON devotees are simply, so just rutting, just ratana, just tote ki tarah try. So what is this meditation we should do? So such a sampradaya, some people are encouraging like this, and ISKCON devotees also going, our devotees get influenced, and a so-called sadhu is there. Of course, I don't want to offend any Vaishnava. So many devotees are leaving our place and going there, even in Vrindavan especially. So their thing is meditation is, so we should meditate on the Radha Krishna actually. So Radha Krishna. So but that is not a artificial thing. For that you need to do the Shravanam Kirtanam. By doing the Shravanam Kirtanam, impurities in the heart will be finished. That means Shrunatam Sakata Punya Shravana Kirtana. So by that means when these are all cleaned, then in that pure heart, you can almost all pure heart. So in that you can easily, so you can meditate on the Lord by that heart. Yeah, Shravanam means what? Nothing. Shravanam means just your sound should go and touch to the eardrums. That's all. That is Shravanam. Yeah. So Shravanam is, you don't need to try to understand the meanings also. You don't need actually. Just Shravanam means this is going and it is touching the eardrums. That is enough. Then that will take care of everything. That is a Shravanam. So that's why Smaranam is a natural thing. It will come automatically. If you are sufficiently, your anardhas are removed. So Nishta stage, that means it's like a type of meditation. So Anudhyana Rupa, Jiva Goswami is saying here. Bhakti Anudhyana Rupa Naishtiki Santata Eva Bhavati. But in the case of Jnana, if you want to meditate on the Brahman, there is a demand of complete purification of the heart. Your heart should not have even a tinge of the impurity or a tinge of the, it is responsive. Finish. You will immediately come down from the Brahman stage to the some material platform, and after that, he will start doing the welfare activities in the society. So then that's the Prabhupada says many times. These Sreyas Srutim Bhakti Mudasya Kleshala Shishyati there. So by leaving the bhakti process, and if someone trying only for the jnana, definitely in their case it is happening. Because the complete eradication, complete purification will happen by the bhakti only actually. Without bhakti, simple jnana cannot do that. That is anyway, that is another topic. Just I am just adding a point here. But here main thing is what? So bhakti. Next, come to the next sloka, next anusheda, 14th. Tadeva tribhuvana vibhava heta vepya kunta smriti ityadyukta ritya sarva vasana nashat chittam shuddha sattva magnam sat bhagavat tattva sakshatkara yogyam bhavati iti aha. What is it saying? It's at 11th canto, 2nd, 50th, Navayogendras. They are saying this statement. Tribhuvana Vibhava Hetave. This is the place where we are seeing the discussion of the so Kanishta, Adhikari, Madhyama and Uttama. The stages of the bhakti is explained in this chapter, 2nd chapter. So in that different stages are there between the Kanishta to Madhyama. So in that, this is also coming. So see the English translation of this. Tribhuvana vibhava hetave pyakunta smritihi ajitatma suradibhir vimrugyat nachalati bhagavati padara vindal lava nimishardhamapi yah sa vaishnavagriha. He is the topmost Vaishnava. So with that, he is the best of devotees whose remembrance is not lured by dominion over the three worlds and who doesn't deviate for half a second from the Lord's lotus feet, which are sought by the devatas who also meditate on Lord Ajita. So what is the main thing you should grasp from this? Why this sloka is quoted here all of sudden? So what is the benchmark for the purification of the heart? What is the benchmark? How can you say, how to measure that your heart is purified? Is there any scale to measure the heart is purified? That scale is given here. So what we said, so when the almost all avadras, that means impurities are cleaned, he will come to the nishtha bhakti. Then everything is cleaned. How to know that? That is indicated here. Tribhuvana vibhava hetave. Tribhuvana means vibhava. Tribhuvana vibhava means wealth in the three worlds. Bhurbhasvaha. In these three worlds, whatever wealth is there, you are going to offer that wealth to a devotee who purified his heart completely. Then, and you will ask him just for momentum, just for one moment, less than 1 second, you leave the lotus feet of the Lord and I will give all this wealth. Then what he will say? No, I don't want. So that is the purification. That is the indication of the heart. Okay.
Those who will say no, and the second time, those who will say yes and offer everything to the Lord.
Yeah, here the main intention is, so we should, main thing is, that means he's completely freed from any kind of impurities are not there. They don't have any attraction for this material wealth. That is the main intention actually. So that's why ityadyukta ritya sarva vasana nashat, completely destruction of the all the desires. So then what will happen? Chittam suddha sattva magnam, then heart is completely pure. So then what will happen? Bhagavat tattva sakshatkara yogyam, that kind of heart is the eligible place. There Lord can appear. Bhagavat tattva sakshatkara yogyam, that heart is really eligible place, eligible heart to get the darshan, to get the presence of the Lord. So that's why, so bhavati ityaha, so this is said in this sloka. Tada rajastamo bhava kama lobadayaschaye chetayetairanaviddham stitam sattve prasidati. So what it means? The mind becomes unaffected by rajas and tamas and their products such as lust, greed and so on. Then the mind being fixed in suddha sattva becomes satisfied. In the case of jnanis, if you ask them also, for them what they will also reject the tribhuvana vibhava. That means wealth of the three worlds. But in that case, what is happening to the heart? Heart is becoming non-reactive. They are not seeing any difference among the objects. Everything is Brahman. No features. Okay? People are sleeping actually. Okay. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Good morning. So, what will happen? So, in the case of jnanis, the heart is becoming the non-reactive. But in the case of devotees, heart is completely cleaned and it is having the so soft. It is so soft that so the mercy of the Lord, which is there in the heart. So because of this softness, so if any non-devotee is suffering in the material nature, if you see, so that soft heart is melted immediately, and that is flowing outside actually. So, and that will carry the mercy of the Lord. That flowing heart will carry the mercy of the Lord. So, and that will go to the new people, and they will also become devotees. What?
I just recently listening to class on Kapila Dev. In the third canto, he's saying that there are three qualities of citta, and one of them is avikaritvam. Yeah. So when the citta is purified, it also becomes avikaritvam. Means it's not vikara is not happening,
yeah.
And it's not changing. Is it the same thing as you're explaining about the jnanis?
In the case of jnani, that is a citta avikaritvam.
But for devotees, there is also a type of avikaritvam.
But in devotees' case, so citta is become more reactive. It's so soft, and it is immediately. So paradukkha dukki, immediately it is melted, and so it is flowing actually. So,
Sadhaka's state chitta is telling, pure devotee when is like uttam adhikari, just we cannot forget even one moment, Lord. That will be all flowing mercy, karuna.
Yeah.
But as sadhaka, about who chitta, just like how will they responding and how bhakti will be taking place?
Sadhaka means which sadhaka?
Struggling sadhaka.
Madhyama?
Yes.
You are saying about Madhyama Adhikari? Yes. His heart only. This Tribhuvana Vibhava Hetave is telling about the Madhyama Adhikari only.
This is Uttama Adhikari. This is not Madhyama.
No. It will come after two slokas. After this, two more slokas will come. So that final sloka will explain. So if you open this context, anyway, this Tribhuvana Vibhava Hetave is not telling about the Uttama Adhikari. So Uttama Adhikari case will come after next to next sloka. In that flow, so if you see it's 11th canto, you will understand there. And that is the Uttama Adhikari stage. That sloka I will just read out. Visrujati hrudayam nayasya sakshat harirashabihitopya gauganashah pranaya rashanaya drutangri padmah sa bhagavati bhagavata pradhana uktah. This is 11th canto, 2nd chapter, 55 is telling about the Uttama Adhikari. Before that, those are all different grades of the Madhyama. Different. That means before this, it's not that the Uttama and Madhyama is, and in between nobody is there. It's not a digital scale. 1, 2, 3. No. There is a grades. There are the it's a gray scale. It is not the black and white. So if you see, these slokas are starting from where? These slokas are. So before that also, na karma na kama karma bijanam yasya chetase sambhavaha vasudevaika nilayaha savai bhagavatottamaha. 50. Do you think he's a Uttama Adhikari? No. So different levels. We will discuss this. This also will come. So we'll discuss whenever it comes. So anyway, we should not go that much into the another topic. So it will, so we'll forget the main theme of this. Okay, now come to this. So what will happen? So when the heart is completely purified in the case of the devotees, that means that heart is free from the rajas tamo bhavaha. That means the products of the rajas and tamas. What are the products of the rajas and tamas? Kama yesha, krodha yesha, rajo guna samadbhavaha. So lust and greed and also other things, tamo guna also is having other. So products all will be so clean. Then heart will be in the goodness. What if you remove the rajas and tamas, it will be in the what? It will be in the remaining is what? Goodness. So it is material goodness? No. Because goodness is also friend of rajas and tamas. If two friends are not there, third friend will not stay there. Because these three are the friends, all together they stay. They never leave the other. Rajas, tamas and sattva. You cannot separate one guna from the remaining two and keep isolate it and you can keep it. And they have the cooperation work. Sattuguna cannot work without rajas. Because rajas is the proactive actually. It will give the sahakaritvam, cooperation to the sattva so that sattva can act. Otherwise, if you isolate keval sattva, then it is not doing any action actually. Even tamoguna also will not do action. So like this, there is a, if you read the Sankhya Tattva Kaumudi, if you understand the science behind the modes, then you will understand. So that's why if these material three qualities are always together. So here, rajas and tamas are completely cleaned means sattva is also out. But still here, that's why here sattvam is said. So what is the meaning of that sattvam? That sattvam is not material sattvam. It is proved or not. Rajas tamo bhavaha kama lobha adayascha cheta yetairana viddam stitam sattve prasidati. What is said? By this continuous chanting, everything is purified. All the feelings of the rajas and tamas is finished. That means there is no effect of rajas and tamas. Means there is no effect of sattva guna also. Then what? Then still it is said stitam sattve prasidati. Then this sattva means you should take Visuddha Sattvam. So, Rajascha Tamascha Yecha Tat Prabhavaha. So that means Rajoguna, Tamoguna and also their effects, everything gone. That's why Sattvaguna and its effect gone. Then it's in the pure goodness. So that's why you should translate sattvam means here pure goodness. So Lord is appearing in that kind of place. In the Bhagavad Sandarbha. We'll discuss in Bhakti Vaibhava course that will come in the 9th chapter, 2nd canto 9th chapter, it will come. So come to the next anuscheda. We'll go to the next anuscheda.
One question, Prabhu.
Yes, Prabhu.
So in previous anuscheda, we discussed about nishtha. And nishtha, after nishtha...
Everything is finished. Nishtha means most of the purification. Almost heart is purified.
Okay.
Now in this 15, completely purified. Then that is the resting place. That is the proper place for the Lord to appear. So that is said in the next sloka. Sri Bhagavate. Evam prasanna manaso bhagavad bhakti yogatah bhagavat tattva vijnanam mukta sangasya jayate. What is the translation, Leela Govind Prabhu? Read translation.
On seeing the Lord in the heart, ignorance is cut. In this way, one whose heart is pleased and who is detached from lusty desires continuously performs bhakti to the Lord, which leads to direct experience of the Lord.
Yes. Evam prasannam. So, since now heart is completely situated in the pure goodness, so that means it's completely blissful actually. Free from the all the lusty desires. So that means who is detached from so lusty desires. Continuously performs bhakti to the Lord, which leads to direct experience of the Lord. Evam prasanna manaso bhagavat bhakti yogataha bhagavat tattva vijnanam mukta sangasya jayate. So being pleased, that means in that blissful state, by continuous doing the process, That means now heart is purified, immediately Lord is coming. So by the process of cleaning, every day if you hear, heart is purified. So now by your sadhana, you purified the heart. Now, my dear Lord, my heart is purified. Now you have to sit and come and show your darshan. Can you say like this? It's not. What is said here? Even after cleaning of the heart, Bhagavad Bhakti Yoga Taha, Bhagavat Tattva Vijnana Mukta Sangasa Jayate. That means his heart is purified and he is completely free from all lusty desires and it is clear. Then after that, by doing the bhakti, he will be getting the direct experience of the Lord. Means what? Simply, you can, after purifying your heart, you cannot demand the appearance of the Lord. If you keep on doing, so if Lord is willing, he may give darshan. Otherwise, he may ask you to come for next time and we'll do that. Like Narada Muni. So by the association of his Bhakti Vedantis, within 4 months, he come to the stage of which stage? Prema Ankuram. Come to the stage of Prema. Just Ankuram. So, but Lord is just gave the little darshan and he left. So there, but he's having little impurities, murchita kashayas. So even after purifying that, so whenever Lord wants to give his darshan, then only he will give. You cannot demand. Lord cannot be attained by any of these 4 processes, like utpatti, next, utpatti, vikruti, next, samskara and prapti. Utpatti, prapti, vikruti and samskara. These are the 4 processes. By these processes, you cannot get. That means you cannot produce Lord. Utpatti. Like how you are producing the rice. You cannot produce rice or not. You can produce rice. But you cannot produce Lord. That means Lord is not the process. Getting Lord means it's not the process of production. And next, prapti. You cannot achieve the Lord. Achievement means, like prapti means, example is, so you are the gold medalist in your Bhakti Vaibhava course. So you got the first rank and you will be given gold medal. That means that is compulsory. That is achievement. Lord is not the object of any achievement. Lord is not the object of any production process. Lord is also not the object of any vikruti. Vikruti means like you are taking the curd, milk and adding something to that. And it is taking the shape of curd. That's a vikruti. He's also not that kind of, he's not the object of any process of vikruti. And samskara. Samskara means just removing the impurities. So you are removing the impurities in your heart and then Lord immediately appearing. Is it like that? No. Samskara means now you take the gold in the raw form. It is mixed with the earth material and different impurities. And now if you remove all these earth materials, dust and other thing, mud, then there is a pure gold. Gold can be achieved by the samskara, but Lord cannot be achieved by any process of samskara. Then how he is achieved, how he will available, how he can get? By Lord's mercy. By his own mercy you can get. Not by your process. Not by your endeavor. No. Endeavor is these 4 types. Utpatti, prapti, vikruti, samskara. So that is the point we are seeing here. So after purification of the heart also, if keep on doing the bhakti by his mercy, you can get darshan. You get the card.
So you gave this 4 example. Yeah. Where is this mention? Means like that?
Is another in the Bhagavatam only. It is said in the by the Brahmaji says in the glory in the 10th canto 14th chapter. Brahmaji says, glorify the Lord. Okay. My dear Lord, you are not achieved by any of these. Tenth canto, 14th chapter, sloka number, I don't remember. I don't know. Okay, next Anusheda. In the previous class also I told. Good. So now see the Sanskrit verse. Evam purvokta prakarena prasanna manasastato mukta sangasya tyakta kamadi vasanasya bhakti yogatah punarapi kriyamana tasmad vijnanam sakshatkaro manasi bahirva bhavanam vinaiva anubhavah yah sajayate. So English is English translation. Read Akshay Hari Prabhu.
By the previously mentioned method, evam, the heart is pleased. Then being relieved from the all lusty desire, mukta sangase, and because of performing bhakti again, bhakti yogata, one thus get direct perception, vijnanam, of the Lord in the heart or externally, that is experiencing without conception.
Now there is no bhavana. Here there is no, bhavana is not necessary here. There is no need to have a conception. Here now Krishna is appearing in your heart, not in the form of conception, but he is appearing directly. Who is there in the Goloka? That Krishna, Yashodanandan, he is appearing directly. I don't know when we'll get that. So he's directly appearing. So nice. So vijnanam means is here what? What is the meaning of vijnanam? Vijnanam means sakshatkaraha, direct perception. Eye to eye. Direct perception is vijnanam here. And punarapi kriyamanaha. That means once again doing. That means heart is purified by the doing bhakti, nishtha bhakti. But still by doing, continually doing the bhakti, so then what will happen? So Lord will be giving the darshan direct. Mukta sangasya. And where? Inside and outside. Inside means in the heart, he can directly giving his darshan. Like for the Narada, how many things happened? To the Narada, when in this that means in the previous life Narada, so for a few moments he experienced. So what kind of experience he got? Just is out of topic, just I'm asking. He became object for eyes, ears, and nose. Only for these three senses, Lord was through these three. That means he appeared in the heart and three vrittis related to these three senses are formed. That means Narada was smelling the aroma of the coming from the Lord, and Narada is also hearing the ankle bells of the Lord, and Narada is also able to see the face of the Lord. But Narada is not able to touch and taste. These two didn't happen. For that, so Krishna said, "You, my dear, you wait. You wait. You know, in that same body. So you time, you take time. So at the end, he will get the Siddha Deha finally. Okay. So now here, in this case now, he is experienceable for the all the senses. When they are completely, in this locker what we are seeing, for all the senses inside and also outside. Externally also is appearing. He may appear externally and you can see and touch and smell everything. And also inside. Antar Bahirva. So Manasi Bahirva Bhavanam Vinayiva Anubhavaha Yasajaya. So there is no need to have the conception. Oh, Lord is this concept. No, not concept. Directly is experiential. Thank you very much. So questions? Two notes? Okay, he's asking, so our Madhav, so you want to have the file separately? Mula is, and yes, everyone wants separately. This is good actually. Unnecessarily, you don't need to scroll all the time. Scrolling here and there, so much time. Sri Chand Prabhu, yes, question. Unmute it.
Prabhu, yes, Prabhu. Prabhu, the Krishna appears as Bhavana in Anucheda 12. We said that when we are hearing topics of Krishna and hearing his holy names, he appears as a conception. And the lusty desires are gradually removed. Yes. So there, it is only hearing and hearing about Krishna, or like deity worship and all other activities are included too.
Yeah, any process, it will purify. But anarthas, whatever are there, especially anarthas, if you see the Madhuri Kadambani, so anarthas are removed, especially Nama Aparadhas. So 10 offenses towards the holy name. Those will be removed by only now, that's just by glorifying the name. That means Nama Sankirtan only can do that, not other processes. That means whatever offenses did for the holy name, those will go by the only chanting. Shravanam Kirtanam.
Then for other sampradaya, how it will go through?
Other sampradayas, they also have the, so Nama Sankirtan, if you see Madhva Sampradaya, if you see Purandar and others, Kanakadas, so they gave the importance to the holy name. So they were chanting, and also you'll be seeing even in the Ramanuja also gave the holy name. Yeah, Ramana Sampradaya also, they are also having the holy name. But they prominently they do deity worship, but they also chant. They also chant. Yeah. Kirtan also they have. They have the Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudeva, something is there. No? Very Narayana mantras are there. Om Namo Narayana. Many mantras are there. They are. Okay. Arjun Saka Prabhu.
Prabhu, in the Anuchet 13, yes. I could not understood the Vaktir Anirgala Sabhavattam Uktam. Please, can you repeat that Anirgala? Vaktir Anirgala Sabhava. Mane Bhakti ka...
Nirgala Sabhava, Prabhu. Bhakti Nirgala.
Nirgala Sabhava, what does it mean? Can you repeat?
Actually, yes, Prabhu. So here, what is happening in the case of the Jnana and Bhakti? We are comparing actually here. So in the process of Jnana, so if you want to meditate on the Brahman, so through the Jnana process, so there is a need of complete destruction of all the anarthas. But in the case of the Bhakti, so in the Nishta means what? Anudhyana Rupa. We are hearing here. So Nishta means Bhakti. Nishta Bhakti. Naishtiki Bhakti means Anudhyana Rupa. Means meditating on. It's also come to the stage of meditation on the Lord. So this kind of meditation doesn't demand complete destruction of the impurities. Prayaka. Nashta Prayesha means almost. So that's why Bhakti is bold enough actually. It is so bold. Nirgala means you can say, so it is not expecting, it's not having full conditions like Jnana. In the case of Jnana, complete destruction is necessary. Here it is not necessary. That's the point, Prabhu. Yeah. Okay, Ashray Gaurang Prabhu.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. In the text number.
Yes, Prabhu.
26 in this 15 anucheda. Manasi, in the mind the Lord appear.
Where, Prabhu? In anucheda number?
To the 15, that sloka commentary.
What is that?
There is mention that Lord appears not conceptual but real form of Lord.
Okay. That one, Prabhu. So that is.
It is said that Manashi Bahirva, in mind or outside. So my question is that Lord appears in the mind,
yeah.
Really, real form appears, and also in the mind also conceptual also lot appear. So how can one discriminate whether one, when one, somebody may say, okay, I saw the Lord, but that Lord he saw, was it conceptual or the real Lord he saw? That how to discriminate that?
So conceptual or otherwise the real, that means directly without any concept. So this is experienced actually. So that difference will be there. Direct perception. So I, for example, you see, you have seen Delhi previously. Now that concept of Delhi is there with you, and now you can just remember that and you can recall that. So that is different. Now you went to that place and you saw. So that's why then that experience is different. Here what will happen, Prabhu, when Lord is appearing, direct perception, that means it's pratyaksha. That is a pratyaksha pramana actually. Direct experience. And conceptual means it's not pratyaksha.
But it is in mind, in the mind.
Ah, Prabhu, in the mind also, see what will happen. In the case of Narada, that's why I gave example. So when Lord appeared in the heart, so he was becoming experienceable to the senses also, because senses, sense experience, you'll get what? Senses are just taking the output. So like example, some rasagulla is there outside. So our eyes are going, antakarana is going through the eyes and the vritti is formed, and that vritti is giving the experience in the seeing also. Now Lord is appearing inside heart and he is creating those vrittis. So like that. So that's why he's even he's inside, but that is a direct experience only. Yeah. Okay, Prabhu.
Thank you.